Lord, we thank God for your Lord. We thank you, God, for your goodness. Thank you, God, for the word of the Lord. God, as we go into the word today, let the people of God be fed. Let them get insight into your word. Oh God, open up our understanding of your truths as we glean from the word of the Lord. And the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, lead us into and guide us into all truth. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Last week I dealt on a strong topic concerning God has left the building and his presence has vacated the premises of organized religion, organized churches that put so much premium upon facilities and church buildings and edifices, and sometimes less upon the people of God. We must learn to invest more in God's people and less in location and the geography and the physical building that houses the people of God. We have to understand that God called us to minister to people, not to minister to the church building. And so our focus must not be on trying to acquire real estate for our personal aggrandizement, for somebody to look good and to say that I have a big church, a large church, based on the size of the building. It's not just necessarily also the size of the individuals within the building, because many individuals, if they are not fully, hallelujah, converted and they are not transformed in their mind and they are not saved, then that doesn't mean much. The individuals that you have within the church must also be saved, must be transformed, must be moving from a state of glory to glory, from faith to faith in Christ Jesus. And so if they just come to church and just to warm the benches and just to give an offering and then move on, then we have not truly fulfilled our role as church pastors and leaders. Our purpose must be to bring people into knowledge of the truth, into grow in the grace and the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ, and to the stature of perfection in Jesus Christ. Perfecting the saints, edifying the body of Christ, and letting them be to do the work of the ministry. And so I don't want to do much preaching today. As much as I want to do is a little teaching, because there is going around in Christendom and in our churches and in this sense of apathy and laziness and lethargicness, because no one wants to deal with the truth of scripture. The church has now become an arm of the state. Hallelujah. Some people bring politics into the pews, and so as a result, no one wants to speak and preach and teach truth. And when we have someone who is willing to preach and teach truth, they are ostracized and they are looked down upon because they're there to say such certain things is wrong, because we want to get along. And we see this even in the Old Testament prophets. Hallelujah. When we see that people was always trying to silence good people, people of faith. And so we see this even in Nehemiah's time. You see, Nehemiah was living under the bondage, under the occupation, as it were, of Babylon. And then the Persian came, and he was the cup bearer to the king. And he had a burden on his heart to rebuild the temple that was destroyed by Nebuchadnezzar. Remember, I said last week, Solomon built the first temple. And that temple, by what the historian Josephus has mentioned, that temple lasts for 476 years. And so, but Nebuchadnezzar destroyed it. And so we see here Nehemiah trying now, and God, and he got permission from the king of Persia to go and rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. And so, however, as he was doing the work of the Lord, there comes some individual that came and tried to stop the work of God. They tried to use all type of subterfuge and trying to delay him from completing the work. And so we see in Nehemiah chapter 6, verse 2, and it says here, hallelujah, and Sanballat and Geshem sent unto me, saying, come, let us meet together in someone of the village in the plain of Ono. But they thought to do me mischief. Hallelujah. These were Jews, fellow Jews. Hallelujah. Tried to bar Nehemiah from doing the work that God has placed upon him. Hallelujah. Even the king of Persia gave him the money and the finances and the manpower to go rebuild the walls of the temple, the walls of Jerusalem, because he was burdened to see that the wall was destroyed after 70 years of captivity in Babylon. He came back and it was in ruins. And so he's trying to rebuild the wall and do the work of the Lord. And but verse 3 says, and I sent messengers unto them, saying, I am doing a great work. Hallelujah. So I cannot come down. And so we have to understand that sometimes people want you to leave the work from what you're doing. Hallelujah. You're on your wall building and rebuilding the breaches. Hallelujah. You are busy praying for your children and your grandchildren and your family and your marriage. Hallelujah. You're praying for your neighborhood, but someone wants to ask you to come, leave what you're doing. Hallelujah. So that they can create a mischief and a delay. So Nehemiah said, no, I can't come down from the great work that I am doing. And I'm here to tell someone, do not stop doing the work. Don't come down from the high places that God has set you up to do. And so we have here that he said, I cannot come down. Why should the work cease while I leave it and come down to you? Hallelujah. And so he's saying these things now because he recognized that the enemy is trying to sabotage the work of the Lord. Hallelujah. They're trying to make a mischief. Hallelujah. And so as a result, they're trying to allow the work of God to be delayed. Hallelujah. And so we see here as it goes on to verse 12. And lo, I perceive that God had not sent him. Sent who? So what has happened then? They got a so-called prophet. Hallelujah. Prophet and said, come, I have a word for you. Come and leave the job. Come and leave. And say, I have a word of prophecy. But Nehemiah, hallelujah, Holy Ghost, hallelujah, was not necessarily with him at the time, but God has given them the anointing of the Holy Ghost over them. And he said, I perceive that God had not sent him the false prophet. And so you see, even in the church, hallelujah, many people want to stop the work of God. And they may even send a prophet, so-called prophets. Sometimes they inveigle your best friends, even your mentor, to try to stop you from doing God's work. They're trying to silence you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Nehemiah said, I perceive that he was a saint. Hallelujah. But he pronounced this prophecy against me for Tobiah and Sanballat had hired him. We have some people that are want to prophesy for hire. Hallelujah. They are hired prophets, hired hitmen in the spirit, trying to sabotage God's people, trying to sabotage the the work of God in the church. Hallelujah. You are building the preachers, building the church, building up the people. But someone want to tear it down. And they're going to hire people to try to stop you, to speak negative things about you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But Nehemiah wouldn't bite. And so you have to understand that God has called us. Hallelujah. Say hallelujah. We are on our wall and we won't come down. Hallelujah. Say that. I'm on my wall and I won't come down. And I will come down. And so you see here that we see, hallelujah, even in this passage of scripture, that there may be people come sent, hallelujah, trying to sabotage God's work. Hallelujah. They see something within you and they hate it. They are jealous. Hallelujah. And they want to sabotage the work. Hallelujah. They want to set up meetings. Hallelujah. To sabotage the work. Hallelujah. But God said, hallelujah, don't watch their faces. Yet don't watch their faces. Yet he said that to Jeremiah. Hallelujah. Jeremiah was a prophet. Someone said he was a weeping prophet. And so God spoke to Jeremiah. Hallelujah. Because God don't do that. Hallelujah. He would have gone through a situation in his life where he had to speak to the people, the children of Israel. And before the Babylonian captivity, Jeremiah spoke to Israel and said, if you do not cease from doing evil, God's going to send an army, a great army. Hallelujah. He was talking about King Nebuchadnezzar. And so Nehemiah is before, hallelujah, hallelujah, chronologically before Nehemiah's time. And so we see here, Jeremiah, Lord, God spoke to Jeremiah. And in Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 4 says, then the word of the Lord came unto me saying, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. Before you were conceived. Hallelujah. So that is something about people who want to have abortion. That God sees an individual before even they are conceived. Hallelujah. Can we abort? Hallelujah. God's people and God's anointed one. Hallelujah. Every one of us have a purpose. And so God was before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee, and before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee and I ordained thee a prophet unto the nation. And so Jeremiah was a prophet. He was ordained not by man. Hallelujah. He didn't go up to the council and be ordained. He was ordained by God to be a prophet to the nations. Hallelujah. And then said I, Lord, oh Lord, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a child. You see, at this time he was a young man. I thought, I hope I can be anointed to be a prophet. And God says, but the Lord said unto him, unto me, say not that I am a child, for thou shalt go to all that I shall send thee, and whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak. And so, God, you can't keep quiet. Hallelujah. God said, you will ever send you, speak the truth. Hallelujah. You can't be politically correct. Hallelujah. You're going to speak it. And speak it firm. And speak it sure. And so he said, don't you want, you got to speak it. Be not afraid of their faces. Hallelujah. Don't look upon their horrible face. Or their horrified face. They're going to give you the gaze. They're going to say, you can't do this. You shouldn't speak like this, Jeremiah. But I come to tell a preacher. I come to tell the saints of God that you don't watch what they're saying. Don't watch what they say when you post on Facebook and you're posting the word of God and the truth. Hallelujah. And then all the naysayers come out from the woodwork trying, hallelujah, hallelujah, to despise the word, to despise prophesying. Hallelujah. God, don't watch their faces. Hallelujah. Don't watch what people say when you know the word of truth. Hallelujah to God. Hallelujah. Don't watch their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. And then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said unto me, behold, I have put my words in thy mouth. Hallelujah, hallelujah. See, I have this day set thee over the nations, over the kingdoms, to root out. Hallelujah. Sometimes you have to pluck up some things. You have to root out some wickedness and mischief. Hallelujah. With your speech. Some hate speech needs to be rooted out. Hallelujah. Some wickedness needs to be rooted out. Hallelujah. But most preachers don't want to touch that. They want to give you all the fables and the nice story about the gospel. Hallelujah. I come to tell you, every preacher, every true man of God had to suffer persecution because they're telling the truth. I will see Jeremiah suffered. Hallelujah. They locked him up in jail. They threw him in dungeon. Hallelujah. And he was mourned. They would strip naked, so try to get their attention. Hallelujah. Because God, he knows the impending judgment. And so we see this even with Paul. Hallelujah. He was persecuted many a times. He was whipped. Hallelujah. Yes, we see all of the apostles. Hallelujah. James. Peter was crucified upside down because he preached and speak truth. Because he dared to speak truth to power. Hallelujah. James was cast off a high tower. He was the pastor of the Jerusalem saints. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And Paul was beheaded and was put in hot oil. Hallelujah. John was. And they left him for dead, but God let him survive. All the apostles died as martyrs. And you are now in the church. And because someone says, you don't say that you shouldn't speak against homosexuality, then you get quiet. Then you get silent. Hallelujah. Somebody say, hey, because somebody said that you must not say anything against the synagogue of Satan. Yes, you go Google that and see in Revelation chapter 2 and 9 and chapter 3 and 9 who are the secret, hallelujah, individual in the synagogue of Satan. Hallelujah. They don't want to preach that. Hallelujah. What preach all the nicest stuff. Hallelujah. But I come to preach truth. I come to preach truth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I won't be silent. Hallelujah. So you see here. Hallelujah. In. Hallelujah. In Jeremiah 20. Hallelujah. Jeremiah 20 verse 7. And Jeremiah said, oh Lord, thou art deceived me. Yes. Oh, Jeremiah said, I preach it. And God, I didn't know I would have been gone through so much. Hallelujah, heartache. I didn't know my friends would have left me. I didn't know that I would have been imprisoned. I didn't know that people would talk negative against me. But God, you deceived me. I was deceived, though art stronger than I. I was prevailed. I has prevailed. Hallelujah. I am in derision daily. Everyone mocked me. Yes, they mocked Jeremiah. Other people said, God, how could you give me such an anointing? Or could you tell me to preach the word when you know that's what's going to happen? Hallelujah. But I come to tell someone, don't watch their faces. Don't stop because of what they say. Let them keep mocking. Let them keep cheering. Because God has put a word in my mouth. God has put a word in your mouth to speak the truth of God. And so they mocked me, said Jeremiah. For since I spake, I cried out. I cried violently, strongly, and swore, because the word of the Lord was made a reproach unto me. And a derision daily. Daily they mocked me. Cheer me. Oh God, I become the outcast of the community. Hallelujah. Then I said, I will not make a mention of God anymore. I will not speak about Jesus because God, they want to kill me. They want to assassinate the prophet. They want to, God, take me out. They want to eliminate me from the church. Eliminate me from there, from the companion.
fellowship and your fellowship. Hallelujah, yes, God. So I said, I'm going to keep quiet. Hallelujah, I won't say anything about your favor. I won't warn anybody. Oh, I said, I'm going to keep quiet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, I will not make mention of him, nor speak anymore in his name. I will not speak about Jesus. I will not speak about Jehovah. Because God, the overwhelming persecution is too much to bear. But his word, hallelujah, his word, Jeremiah says, was my heart as a burning fire. Hallelujah. I said I wouldn't tell it to a living soul. I said, God, why I put this message in my mouth? God, don't you know that all of Christendom is backing. They're getting deception. And they don't know that they're supporting the synagogue of Satan. Yes, there is a blindfold. Yes, they don't see. And they're scapegoating others. Hallelujah, they can't see. God, they don't see what they're doing. Hallelujah, when they're peeking. And so I said, God, I can't bear this. I don't want to say anything else. I want to be quiet. I want to be politically correct. But God, I wake up in the morning and I have the word on my mind. I go to bed at night and I have the word on my mind. It's like fire. I try to keep it. I try to be a good Christian. I preach what everybody preaches. I want to be a good pastor. I speak whatever the watered down religion that everybody speaks. But God, the word feels like burning fire in my bones. And so Jeremiah says, hallelujah, but his word was in my heart as a burning fire shut up in my bones. I was weary with forbearing. I could not stay. I could not keep quiet. Hallelujah. I could not keep quiet, for I heard the defaming of many. They defame my character. Hallelujah. Fear on every side. Reproach. Their report. They send report to the church body, to the headquarters. Lord, they reported me. They reported me to this group. I don't want to take me off here and take me off there. But God says, hallelujah, but say, a report said they, and now we will report it. Hallelujah, all my familiars, all my families, all my friends, all my preacher friends, yes, all of them has risen up against me. They're risen up against Jeremiah. They're risen up. All my familiars watched for my falling, watch for my halting, watch that saying, prevent your evil, he will be enticed. They tried to bribe me, but I would not speak the lie. I can't speak that. If it's not what God said, I won't speak it. They tried to entice me, and he shall prevail, and we shall prevail against him. Hallelujah. And we shall take over our revenge on him. But the Lord is with me as a mighty, terrible one. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God has protected me. God has, hallelujah, given me power. God has given me the anointing to speak the truth, to prevail over the nations, to prevail over those. Oh God, hallelujah, they hire other people. Oh, even my best buddies, even those around me, they are hired to take me out, to come close to me. Hallelujah, trying to stop the word of God. Hallelujah. And God said, hallelujah, I'm on the wall. We are on our wall, and I won't come down. I will not be silenced. I will not be silenced. Hallelujah. 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 When you go to Acts chapter 20, we see this now. We saw Jeremiah in the Old Testament being persecuted. Hallelujah. Now we come to the apostle, because remember, the church is built upon the prophets of Jeremiah, Isaiah, and all those, and the apostles, Paul and Peter and James and John, and Jesus Christ being the chief cornerstone, and all of them were persecuted. Jesus Christ, the prophets and the apostles, they all killed all of them. Yeah, Jews killed all of them. The religious people killed all of them. The church people, religious people killed all of them. I guess I said it. Hallelujah. Is it the word? Yes, they killed them. I don't care if you want to be politically correct. It's in the word. Hallelujah. The chief priest killed and crucified Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so we see here, hallelujah, Acts 20, hallelujah, and 22, Paul is talking to some preachers. Paul called a pastor's meeting, a pastor's seminar, hallelujah, and he called all the pastors to come gather, hallelujah, and so he said, hallelujah, he called them from the Egypt. Verse 17 says, from Miletus, Paul sent to Ephesus and called the elders of the church. He called all the pastors and come to a pastor's meeting. Paul was ready to go to Jerusalem. Hallelujah. And know that he would face the wrath of the Jews. Hallelujah. Even now. Hallelujah. Let me tell you people, I will not, hallelujah, when God given me truth, I got to preach it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so he says in verse 22, and now behold, I go bound in the spirit unto Jerusalem, not knowing the things that shall befall me there, saying that the Holy Ghost witness in every city, saying that bonds and affliction abide me. Hallelujah. That the Holy Ghost confirmed with Paul that he was going to be persecuted and be afflicted. The Holy Ghost. Give God confirm and said that you're going to be afflicted. And so that way he was given a thorn in the flesh, a persecution, a messenger of Satan. A messenger, when he talks about a messenger, he talks about a spirit, like angel, a fallen angel from Satan. A demon was assigned by the devil. I will buffet Peter and buffet Paul on every side because of the level of the anointing and the revelation that was given him. And so Paul challenged, hallelujah, people of God. I don't have much time here, but he preached to the people. He preached to the elders and the pastors, and he said unto them, verse 27, for I have not shunned, I didn't stop, I wasn't afraid to declare or to preach unto you all the counsel, not the part, but all the counsel of God. Hallelujah. So he's saying to them now, he gave them a charge, giving the people, the preachers, the pastors, he said, take heed therefore unto yourselves and to all the flock over which the Holy Ghost has made you overseers. To feed the church of God, you must feed the people, not please them, not invest in church building, but feed the people of God. Invest in the people. I will feed my sheep, feed my lamb, Peter. You got to feed them. You got to give them not just the written or the spoken word, but take care of welfare of their lives. Be concerned, yes, Lord, with people. And not with stones and benches, hallelujah, like some of the preachers. Speak the truth and speak the entire, all the counsel of God. Amen. Hallelujah. And so feed this church of God, which he hath purchased with his own blood. And so he's telling the people, hallelujah, why? Why must you preach? Because, for I know this, that after my departing, after I die, after they kill me, shall grievous wolves enter in among you, come into the church, wolves dressed up like sheep, coming into church, diluting the word of God, and mixing truth and error, and giving it to you, bringing Judaism back into the church. Hallelujah. Deceiving many people. Hallelujah. And but God says, hallelujah. And they're not going to spear the flock. They're going to try to destroy the people. They're going to cut them down and destroy their faith. Hallelujah. And so he says, therefore, watch. Watch and pray. Be observant. You watch. What it means to watch? To have hallelujah. Hallelujah. That understanding. Hallelujah. Spirit. That God can see beyond the spirit realm. Because the children of Issachar, as in 1 Chronicles 32 says, the children of Issachar understood the times. You have to watch and understand the times that you're in. You have to ask God for wisdom. Hallelujah. And revelation. Hallelujah. Watch. And remember that by the space of 3 years, I cease not to warn everyone night and day with tears. And so we see Paul preaching and commanding the people. Yes, you are the people of God. You have been given your Holy Ghost. You have been given your anointing. Not just the preachers. God and the Pentecost. And Acts 2:3-4. Acts 2:3-4 says, the Holy Ghost filled all of them. Yes, all of the apostles and the 120. The 120 that was there. Men and women. The apostles, the leaders, and the lay members. Men and women. Young and old. All was filled the Holy Ghost. Yes, don't tell me it's just for the preacher. No, you have the anointing. You have the anointing to open your mouth and speak the word of God. And I finish it up here. But I need to say one more thing. Hallelujah. Verse 30. Hallelujah. Verse 33. Paul says here, I have come with no man's silver or gold or apparel. So when the preacher wants gold, they want only your money, your tithes, and offering. And they don't care anything about you. But Paul says, I never come with anybody. Hallelujah. Yes, he yourself know that these hands have ministered unto my own necessity. Paul would make tents. He was a tent maker. And we preach and go to the synagogue on the weekends. And what do you week? He worked with his hands. Hallelujah. And to the necessity and to them that were with him. He provides a living. Hallelujah. I have shown you all things. How that so labor he ought also to support the weak. And to remember the word of the Lord Jesus. How he said, it is more blessed. It is more blessed to give than to receive. And that goes for the preachers. It is more blessed to give than to receive. Hallelujah. Covet. Stop coveting the people's money. You're not there to fleece the people. You're there to provide and feed them. You're there to take care of them. And preach the unadulterated word. We have Paul as an example. Hallelujah. That he don't. His desire is not for it to take and take and take. But to give. But to give. Hallelujah. And so we are called that we as a church. The church. What will the church really stand for? What will the church really stand for? Do we stand for something? Do we stand for holiness and righteousness? Hallelujah. Or we just look and talk and preach according to the political wind of the day. Just to be safe. Hallelujah. What will the church really stand up to? We have to be really ready to stand up for something. But we also have to also be really to stand up to and stand up against the forces amongst ourselves, within the church, within Christendom, and preach the truth. The children of Issachar had an understanding of the times. And you must preach and open up your Bible and preach not what other preachers say, not what other political preachers say, not what is all political expedient, and everybody wants to say, and be silent. Don't allow the synagogue of Satan silent anywhere. Hallelujah. You stand up for righteousness and true holiness, speaking the unadulterated word of God. Like Jeremiah, they're going to persecute you. But like Jeremiah, God said, I'll be with you. I will be with you. I will be with you. I will guide you. I will guide you. And though the word may be in you, you preach it. It's like fire. Shut up with these red bones. I've got to speak it. If I don't, woe is me, Isaiah said, if I speak not the word of God. Hallelujah. Some people can speak, preach, and I don't mind them. They can preach of your hope and grace and wonderful stories and stuff. But for some of us, as prophets of God, we have to preach the hard things and call people to warning and call people to repentance and to say, stop it in Jesus' name. To stop the wickedness and the violence and the hate speech. Hallelujah. To stop it against law-abiding citizens. Hallelujah. We must know to repel the wicked and the violent without killing and walking the death of innocent people. Hallelujah. God wants, God is against shedding of innocent blood. Whoever that blood is, you're warning Israel about that. And it's warning the Christian church, you're warning America. Hallelujah. That we taunt. Hallelujah. That we don't draw the sword on the wrong people or against our own. Lord Jesus, we thank the Lord in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.